So, guys, what we're gonna do now, so pull guard, we're in the transverse guard, and I pulled him over top, and for whatever reason, I wasn't able to get the sweep. He is able to retreat so that his weight's not up over me anymore, and now he's in front of me again. So, first thing I'm gonna, when he comes back in front of me here, guys, he's not gonna, well, he might stay here, and again, if he stays on his feet, I'm just gonna go again, we're gonna try it again. But smart guy's probably gonna feel like his base has been compromised, he's probably gonna start getting himself lower to the ground. So what we're gonna do, or what he's gonna do, is he's gonna go down to combat base. He's just gonna put his left knee down to the mat, keep his right knee driving in my hip. Yeah, exactly, good. And the reason why it's particular about which side he's gonna put his knee up, which is because this is gonna be harder for me to remove, unless I remove my spider hook, which would be a mistake for me, whereas if he goes the other way, switch. I can start taking the base up with my free leg here and attacking. So we want to make sure that we have the knee up on the side that the spider's on. It also can help him like fight this hook, if you drive the shin, my thigh and stuff. So it's just a stronger position for him in terms of defense here. So what I'm going to do now, guys, is I want to bring my leg, like the one that's underneath him, I want to bring it to the outside of him. So I'm just going to bring my foot out and step the outside here, and my goal is just to bring his elbow. Okay, so we're pretty much going to do the same thing we did to off balance him while he was standing. I'm going to be bridging with my right foot off the mat, I'm going to be pulling with my grips, and bringing his elbow off the mat over here. And when I do this, guys, I pull him over, I bring his elbow to the mat, he needs to make sure that he stays in good base. Just go over here, please. Let's put your elbow down. So when we get this way a bit. When we get here, guys, and his elbow's on the mat, he needs to make sure that he's not going to get, like, if he puts both knees down on the mat, it's just, again, an easy triangle, so he's going to make sure that he puts his other shin up, move my groin as well to your elbow, so that I can't just easily throw my triangle up, okay? So what we're going to do from here, guys, I got to remove this leg. It's not a big deal. I can do exactly what I just showed before. I'm going to go shin to shin, so if I have to, I'm going to hip out. Get my. I'm gonna hook his ankle with mine. Lift his leg up. Just slide down my own leg. Step on his hip. So I'm basically kind of in like a modified single leg X position now. From here, guys, I can afford to let the collar go because I have my foot on the hip, which is now controlling the distance for me. I'm still pulling on his hip on his sleeve here. I underhook his leg, grab the pants, and then we're just gonna complete the sweep similarly to the way we did the last one. I'm gonna bring my toes under his hip, stepping like on his belt knot. My left foot's gonna chop in as I push with my right leg, and I'm gonna just follow it up to the on belly. Okay? You can practice too, guys, with a few different ways of coming up. Like, realistically, you're probably not gonna come up to the on belly. The guy's gonna start fighting back and regarding and stuff, and so there'll be like a scramble or an exchange there that many variables can happen. So, like, feel free to like play around with how you finish. Finish the sweep. Let's come back. Again. We're in tarantula guard. He lowers his base. He's got his knee in my hip. I step on the mat. I want to bring his elbow to the mat. So again, the idea, guys, is I just keep my foot tight on his bicep. If I bring my foot over there, and my foot is glued to his bicep, the rest of his body has to go there too. So I, boom! He brings up his base. I hip out so that I have some room for my toes to go inside. I lift the leg up, it slides down to my hip. I step on the hip, let the collar go, underhook his leg. And guys, don't grab the leg like this, okay? I wanna underhook it just so that it's nice and easy for me to lift up when I come up. Here, it'll be like a lot of play. When I underhook it though, it'll be like stuck on top, it'll be shelved on top of my forearm. I come under the hip with my toes, knee stays out. I'm pushing, while I chop in with my left leg, and boom. You could like, again, I'm pulling on the sleeve and pushing the leg away to try to swing the hips away. Bringing my foot on the mat, and the knee on belly. Do you need this? You do need this? Second category. Come on, master. Again. Okay. Got the guard set up. I already threw his balance forward. He didn't like it. He lowered his base. He got his shin in my hip. Controlling grips. Bring my hip up, or my foot up to the outside. I'm bridging as I pull it forward, bring his elbow to the mat, he switches his base. Good, yeah, I gotta keep this elbow on the mat too, guys. If you get kind of in a battle here, I'm trying to keep this this elbow on the mat. The way I'm gonna keep heavy on it, guys, is with this foot, I'm slightly lifting my hip up so that I can transfer the weight into my left ankle, okay? That's an important detail if you aren't quick at getting your shin to shin here and getting this leg up and sliding your foot onto the hip. From here, you're gonna go with the collar, go underneath the leg, grab the pants, come under the butt, kick, chop, pull on the sleeves if you want. Any questions? Let's do that. One, two.